Morning dear cadets, so as you know in the previous video I was teaching you characteristics of chemical adsorption. So the first two characteristics of chemical adsorption I have covered, enthalpy of adsorption and irreversibility. Now the third one characteristics is effect of temperature. So in case of physical adsorption, what was there? With the increase of temperature, the rate of physical adsorption was decreasing. What about this one? It means in case of chemical adsorption, what is the effect of temperature? With the increase of temperature, initially the rate of chemical adsorption increases, but up to certain extent only. Afterwards, it starts decreasing regularly. So the question arises here, why initially the rate of adsorption increases with the increase of temperature, then it starts decreasing? Very simple reason is there. Actually, chemical adsorption is required activation energy. It is activated adsorption. What is this one? Activated adsorption, one thing. Second one thing, in chemical adsorption, between adsorbate and adsorbent, chemical bond is there, unlike physical adsorption. In physical adsorption, what is there? Chemical bonding is not there between adsorbate and adsorbent. In case of chemical adsorption, what is there? Chemical bonding is required between adsorbate and adsorbent. Then what is there? Chemical bonding can only be possible, means new bonding is only possible between adsorbate and adsorbent when old bond gets broken. And for breaking of old bond, what is required? Energy is required. That is why initially whatever amount of energy in the form of heat or temperature you have supplied, that is utilized to break the old bond, so that the new bond between adsorbate and adsorbent should form. So here I wrote here, it needs some activation energy. Activation energy, why it is needed activation energy? Activation energy needed to break the old bond only, so that new bond should form. So it is written here, initially increases up to certain extent, then starts decreasing regularly. Chemical adsorption needs some activation energy, hence initially with the increase of temperature it increases. So the more clarification of this one, activation energy, I have explained you why activation energy is required. It requires just for breaking the old bond, so that if old bond is broken, then only new bond will form between adsorbate and adsorbent. So in this way, this effect of temperature is over. And distinction is also over. Here only I am distinguishing between physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. In physical adsorption, what is there? The rate of physical adsorption decreases with the increase of temperature, while the rate of chemical adsorption increases with the increase of temperature, because in chemical adsorption, chemical bonding is possible between adsorbate and adsorbent. So now I am moving to the fourth one characteristics, that is specific in nature. So as you know, chemical adsorption is highly specific in nature. It is highly specific in nature. So just try to understand. Fourth one, highly specific. So I hope that you are understanding the meaning of highly specific. What do you mean by highly specific? Means all adsorbate will not be adsorbed at the surface of all adsorbent. Means one particular adsorbent can adsorb one particular adsorbate only. Are you getting my point or not? I am giving you example. Just see, oxygen will not adsorb at the surface of transition metal like nickel, chromium, manganese, but hydrogen can adsorb. That is, last year you have studied na different types of hydrides of transition metal. So stoichiometric hydride, you studied. What kind of hydride they are? They are formed because of this only, adsorption only, because hydrogen gas adsorb at the surface of palladium. Have you heard or not? Occlusion. So what is there? Chemical adsorption is highly specific. The meaning of highly specific means one particular adsorbent can adsorb one particular adsorbate only. It is not general that all adsorbate will adsorb at the surface of all adsorbent. So it is highly specific. So here one point you write. One particular adsorbent can adsorb one particular adsorbate. Okay, that is the meaning of highly specific. Now question arises here, why chemical adsorption is here, you can write why chemical adsorption is specific. So just try to understand, very simple answer is there. In chemical adsorption, chemical bond is formed between adsorbate and adsorbent. So here very simple answer is there. Since chemical bond is formed between adsorbate and adsorbent, so all adsorbate may not react with the particular adsorbent. That is why it is specific in nature. Like just now I have given you example, oxygen cannot react with the nickel transition metal, but hydrogen can react with the nickel. So when oxygen will come at the surface of nickel, so that may be the example of physical adsorption, because in physical adsorption what is there? Chemical bond is not formed. So some extent oxygen may adsorb at the surface of nickel. But as far as chemical adsorption is concerned, oxygen will not do, but hydrogen chemically will react with the nickel. So the chemical bond is formed. So what answer you will write, why chemical adsorption is specific? Because in this adsorption chemical bond is formed. Hence all adsorbate may not form bond with particular adsorbent. This is the reason, that is why it is specific in nature. Now next one is fifth one. Dear cadets, now fifth one, physical state of adsorbate. In case of physical adsorption, what was there? The physical state of adsorbate at the surface and in the bulk, both were same only. But what about in chemical adsorption? The physical state of adsorbate at the surface may be different. From the bulk. Example, just see. Oxygen at the surface of metal. Suppose oxygen is reacting with any type of metal. So oxygen may be present at the surface of that metal in the form of oxide ion, O2 ion, or peroxide ion, or superoxide ion. But in the bulk of the same metal, it will be present in the form of O2 molecules. Are you getting my point or not? So here example you can write, at the surface of metal, oxygen may be present in the form of O2 negative, O2 single negative, or O2 minus half. But in the bulk, it will be in the form of O2 molecules. So just see the surface and in the bulk, the physical state of oxygen is different. At the surface, oxygen is present in the form of ion, but in the bulk, it is present in the form of molecules. Here, oxygen is adsorbed. Now, which is the adsorbent? The metal surface at which it is adsorbing. In this way, dear cadets, your characteristics of chemical adsorption is over. Now, suppose one question arises here. What is the difference between physical adsorption and chemical adsorption? So, whatever characteristics I have noted down here, I have explained you, just summarize them in the tabular form. Your difference is ready. Like, just see, start with the enthalpy of adsorption. In case of physical adsorption, enthalpy of adsorption is less. Even reason also I have explained. In chemical adsorption, it is more. Reason is also there. Selectivity, then reversible, irreversible nature, enthalpy of adsorption, effect of temperature, physical state of adsorbate. These are the sum of the characteristics. Always remember, enthalpy of adsorption means enthalpy of activation is not required in case of physical adsorption. But in case of chemical adsorption, enthalpy of adsorption is required. Enthalpy of activation is required. Why enthalpy of activation is required in chemical adsorption? Because in chemical adsorption, chemical bond is formed between adsorbate and adsorbent. That is why what is there? Some energy is required to break the old bond. Then only new bond will form between adsorbate and adsorbent. That is why enthalpy of activation or energy of activation is required in case of chemical adsorption. In this way, thing is completely completed. One more thing is there that can be included. That is the characteristics number 6. Just try to understand. At the surface of here, you can write heading right. Just formation of one layer of adsorbate at the surface of adsorbent. So just see, in case of physical adsorption, what was there? Multimolecular layer of adsorbate is formed at the surface of adsorbent. But in case of chemical adsorption, what is there? Only single layer is formed. There also explanation is there. Just try to understand. In chemical adsorption, what is there? There should be a chemical bond between adsorbate and adsorbent. So just try to understand. One particular layer adsorbate only will come into contact of adsorbent. Suppose second layer is also there. So second layer molecules will not come into contact of adsorbent. Now you can understand in this way. Suppose suppose this is adjuvant. What is this one? Adjuvant. Okay. And at this surface, what is there? At its surface, what is there? This is the adjuvant. This is the first layer of adjuvant. Write down here, adjuvant. So try to understand here, this layer of adjuvant directly in contact of adjuvant. Am I correct or not? They are the present at the surface of adjuvant. So they will form the chemical bond. What about the second layer? Suppose this is second layer. So second layer is not directly in touch with the surface of adjuvant. They are not directly in touch. Then what is there? There is no case of chemical bond formation. Hence it is not considered to be the chemical adsorption, because in chemical adsorption chemical bond should form. So that is why in chemical adsorption the formation of one layer of adsorbate at the surface of adsorbent is possible. What about in physical adsorption? In physical adsorption, what is there? Chemical bond is not formed between adsorbate and adsorbent. So let it be multimolecular layer. So one difference further you can write, in physical adsorption, what is there? Multimolecular layer is formed. While in multimolecular layer of adsorbate, in chemical adsorption, what is there? Single layer is formed. Multimolecular, monomolecular layer is formed. Here what is written? Formation of one layer. You can write here monomolecular layer. Monomolecular layer of adsorbate. Monomolecular layer of adsorbate is formed. That is why chemical adsorption is highly specific in nature. This is also one of the reason, highly selective. In this way, this is completely completed. Dear cadets, now new topic, that is factors affecting the adsorption of gas on solid surface. So here gas molecules is adsorbate and solid surface is adsorbent. So what are the factors which affect the adsorption of gas on solid surface? The first one is nature of gas. What is the first one? Nature of gas. Just try to understand. There are two types of gases. The first gas is which have got high critical temperature. Already I have explained that one. High critical temperature. Other gas which has got less critical temperature. So I am writing here high critical temperature. And here what is there? Low critical temperature. If critical temperature is high, then what would be there? Easy liquefaction. If liquefaction is easy, so easy adsorption. Okay, easy adsorption. So what we can say, adsorption of gas is related with the critical temperature. And in case if gas has got low critical temperature, then what would be there? Difficult liquefaction. So here what would be there? Difficult adsorption. Okay, so in this way the nature of gas affect the rate of adsorption. Second factor is, always remember, I am not talking of here physical adsorption and chemical adsorption. One gas can only be adsorbed at the surface of solid when it forms chemical bond with the adsorbent, that is solid surface. इन केस ऑफ केमिकल एडजॉर्प्शन, इन केस ऑफ फिजिकल एडजॉर्प्शन केमिकल बॉन्डिंग इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, बट दीज आर द फैक्टर्स विच अफेक्ट. व्हाट इज द सेकंड फैक्टर? नेचर ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट, दैट आल्सो अफेक्ट. नेचर ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट. जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ द नेचर ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट अफेक्ट द एडजॉर्प्शन ऑफ गैस ऑन सॉलिड सर्फेस. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, देर आर वेरियस काइंड ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट. वन एडजॉर्बेंट विच इज नॉट हैविंग रफ सर्फेस, अनदर एडजॉर्बेंट विच इज हैविंग रफ सर्फेस, वन एडजॉर्बेंट विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ लंप, सॉलिड लंप, अनदर एडजॉर्बेंट विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पाउडर. देन विच केस मीन्स रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन वुड बी मोर? इन केस ऑफ पाउडर्ड फॉर्म, इन केस ऑफ हैविंग रफ सर्फेस, द रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन वुड बी मोर. सो हियर व्हाट, हाउ द नेचर ऑफ एडजॉर्बेंट विल अफेक्ट? जस्ट ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड, इफ एडजॉर्बेंट इज हैविंग मोर सर्फेस एरिया, ओके, मीन्स यू शुड टेक इन द पाउडर्ड फॉर्म, यू शुड टेक इट्स रफ सर्फेस, देन रेट ऑफ एडजॉर्प्शन वुड बी मोर. सो हियर व्हाट यू विल राइट, हियर यू विल राइट Adsorbent will adsorb
more gases.
Adsorbent will adsorb more gases if it has got more surface area. More surface area. One thing. And how you can increase the surface area? By taking its powder form. By creating rough surface on its surface. One more thing is there. Try to understand. One particular adsorbent you have taken. I am explaining in terms of chemical adsorption. Suppose gas you have taken as a adsorbent. So that gas must form chemical bond with the adsorbent. Then only it will be adsorbed. Otherwise it will not be adsorbed. So this is the common factor, that more surface area is there, then more will be the rate of adsorption. But in case of chemical adsorption, some other factors are also responsible. Means that gas, here you can write, In case of chemical adsorption, that gas adsorbate gas must form chemical bond. With adsorbent, must form chemical bond with adsorbent. Then only it will be adsorbed. So these are the two factors. What is the third factor? Third factor is surface area. More the surface area, more will be the rate of adsorption. So what do you mean by more surface area? So, dear cadets, now third factor, specific area of adsorbent. Okay, what do you mean by specific area of adsorbent? Surface area available for adsorption in per gram. That is known as specific area of adsorbent. So greater the surface area, greater will be the rate of adsorption. Greater will be the rate of adsorption. And why surface area is affecting? Why greater surface area should be required? Just try to understand. If surface area is more, then greater number of adsorbate will be attracted toward the surface area. If less number of effective means area, specific area for the adsorption is less, only less number of adsorbate will be attracted toward that. That is why surface area should be more. Next factor is temperature. Temperature, just try to understand. The effect of temperature, we can study in two ways. In case of physical adsorption, in case of physical adsorption, and in case of chemical adsorption. So just try to understand. In both way I have explained earlier only. As far as physical adsorption is concerned, rate of physical adsorption increases with increase of temperature. Rate of physical adsorption decreases with increase of temperature. Reason, just try to understand. Adsorbate adsorb at the surface of adsorbent. If you increase the temperature, then what would be there? They will move away because they will gain the kinetic energy and they will move away from the surface of adsorbent. Hence, rate of physical adsorption decreases with the increase of temperature. What about this one, chemical adsorption? Rate of chemical adsorption increases with increase of temperature. With increase of temperature. Reason, in chemical adsorption, what is there? Chemical bond is formed. And for the formation of chemical bond, old bond should be broken. And for breaking of old bond, energy is required. Then only adsorbate will form chemical bond with the adsorbent. That is why when you are giving the temperature, it means you are giving energy of activation for the adsorbate molecules. And if they will have energy of activation, then they will break the old bond. Then only broken atoms will be ready for making chemical bond with the adsorbent. So that is why chemical adsorption rate increases with the increase of temperature. What about effect of pressure? With the increase of pressure, generally adsorption increases if temperature remains constant. If temperature does not remain constant, then what would be there? Adsorption rate will not increase. So that also should be written here. That is the next fifth number factor. What is the fifth number factor? Effect of pressure. Effect of pressure. So rate of adsorption, simple you can write here. Rate of adsorption increases with the increase of rate of adsorption increases with the increase of pressure. If temperature remains constant. Now one more factor is there. The sixth number factor is activation of adsorbent. Okay, so how you will activate the adsorbent? The activation of adsorbent can be done in three ways. See, try to understand. If adsorbate is if adsorbent is activated, then what would be there? Rate of adsorption would be more. So how you can activate the adsorbent? By creating rough surface. Second one, what is the second factor? The second one is by dividing physically means powdered form. Try to understand, if you divide it physically, it means what you are doing? You are increasing the surface area, active forces, free valencies. Means if you are taking the substance adsorbent in powder form, then what is there? You are increasing the surface area. What do you mean by increasing the surface area? More number of free valencies, more number of unbalanced forces. So if more number of unbalanced forces are present at the surface of adsorbent, then more number of adsorbate will be able to make bond. With the adsorbent. So this is there. One more factor is there. By steam treatment. Try to understand. Charcoal. Before using charcoal as a adsorbent, especially for adsorbing the harmful gases, try to understand the areas where mining work is going on, especially coal mines. There so many harmful gases are produced, and the people who are working in the coal mines, always they are given one mask. In that mask, charcoal is used. So charcoal is a good adsorbent for these harmful gases. So before using charcoal as a adsorbent, it should be treated with the steam. So why it is treated with the steam? Very simple thing is there. Try to understand. In charcoal pores, so many harmful gases are adsorbed already. Now when you supply the steam, steam means vapor. So those vapor will go to those pores, and there that water vapor will condense. And when it will condense, so whatever harmful gases are there, they will dissolve in that condensed water, and they will be removed, and the pores of charcoal will be free for the further adsorption of harmful gases. So these are the some of the ways for the increasing the rate of adsorption if you have taken the adsorbent. So activated surface is required for the adsorbent, and for having activated surface, these are the methods. By creating the rough surface, how you will create the rough surface? Scratching, just scratch it, then their surface area will increase. In this way, dear cadets, I have completely completed the factors affecting the rate of adsorption. Now tomorrow I will teach you adsorption isotherm. One more thing is there. These things means this heading is not given in the NCERT book. It doesn't mean that I have taught extra out of syllabus. All these things are there, but in NCERT book, as usual, heading they have not given. So all those knowledge I have compiled in one place, and I taught under this heading. Everything is given, but it is scattered here and there, so I have assembled them. Thank you, and I am hoping that you are getting, because my voice is also okay now. There is no echo production because I purchased the mic also. So I hope that you are comfortable with me now. Thank you.